ramp it up. Can I ramp it up? We're gonna ramp it up. 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 Ramp it up. We're gonna ramp it up. Come on.
Cannot. No. Stop hitting the mic. What have you done with my camera? You done? Go. Enough. No. Okay, that might be better. Okay. So Junior's doesn't want to go down for his nap. And I'm waiting for DoorDash too.
if you can't take it. Okay. But hello, everybody. Get you Arashi. She's not dead. Coraflom fixes that? Yeah, maybe. So I've just fixed up the card here. I kind of got a bit distracted. But there are we all. Happy Tuesday or Monday, whatever you want to call it. Alright, let's see here. Not too bad, so she'll choose it. Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Wait, I have a clap on Raw. Wait, Jinder's having a world Wait. Jinder is having a fucking world heavyweight championship match? Get the fuck out. No way. No way. No way, we're about to get... Oh, God. How many fucking accounts have you got, Craze? Jeez Louise. Hello, Stephanie. Alright, sorry, that's... What's that? Let's see, I'm just going to... Yeah. Dude, fucking, oh my god. That's so many. That's way too many accounts. What you coming for? If you have good memories, why the hell are you forgetting them? One. Put the same as like an email or something. I don't know. Alright, now it's in the main event. Where are they? He's checked out. Where the fuck is this cunt? Get back if you can't take it. Is that Titans? Oh my god. Yeah, we are in for a good night of action here tonight. We continue the Intercontinental Championship tournament. And no Tony Storm tonight either. So it's even better. What's that? just think, we're a bit over 2 weeks away from the Rumble. Here's pushing you today. Nice!
I see my monthly.
Also, you have a show defending his TV title tonight as well, so that's gonna be fun.
Mr. McMahon,
where do you put the chair? Okay, that's enough of that. Speaking of Tony, Thunkless, this is... Yeah, it's got some bubbles. I have some on the way, so... That's all I've got kind of left, so I had to get more. Okay. Alrighty. Oh, what? What phone company? Oh, fucking. Depends what you want. Right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah. Okay, cool. Alrighty. Yeah, no, doing good, man. Doing good. How's the new server going for you? I just can't finally fucking driving. How the closest school today because of a blizzard? Nice. You know, it's not that bad. So, better be safe than sorry. Better be safe than sorry when it comes to shit like that. You want to sort of, you know, at least if everyone's home and when the blizzard hits, you're all good. Fuck. I don't know what the fuck I listen to tonight. Fuck it. Let's just have this. Two big ones, Telstra, Optus. Yeah. I'm an Optus guy, so. But Telstra for the fucking broadband. So yeah. Oh fucking, I had Vodafone when I was a fucking teenager. Okay. Alright. Alright. Let's bring him on in. Let's bring him on in. Now you're not, and you're not getting,
Vodafone had like the PlayStation Vitas.
What?
Yeah, back in the day, Vodafone, they did the PlayStation Vitas. Like they had like a 3G, 4G model or something. I can't remember.
Okay, well there you go.
Yeah, for some reason I was just reminded of that.
Well,
when you guys
Apple does not have a network. Where the fuck is this cunt going? What? This guy's going so fucking weird way. Just watching this guy drive to my house is like, what the hell? Yeah, no, we don't have that. We don't have Apple's phone company.
Yeah, pretty much. We don't really have, like, a major phone company in the way of an Apple or a Samsung here as such. like, no real homegrown phone company as such.
I mean, they had Free as a thing, didn't they?
I think Free was a carrier in the same way as Telstra and Optus. Yeah. I remember they used to sponsor the cricket, so...
Oh, yeah. Okay. Alrighty. So, we're going to start things off with a one-on-one match. Now, it is going to be Juicy J going up against the TCW Undisputed Champion. We're kicking off big here. Bullfrog, wow. Juicy J, let us get it on. Let's go down to the ring. And you'll get
definitely
your screen in a
an
second.
Interesting pairing. Well, it's like, that is an interesting pairing of competitors there. Bobby, Juicy Field, and Bullfrog. Like, you wouldn't expect this pairing, but in TCW, anything goes, as here's the champ.
The following contest is a tornado tag handicap match. Making his way
what?
Representing the Maniacs.
What?
From Adelaide, Australia, weighing in at 265 pounds. The Triple Crown Undisputed.
Junior, did you do something? Junior, what'd you do?
No, hang a minute. If it's a handicap match, then...
What did you do?
What side gets the handicap?
What did you do? I know it was you. You've done something. What'd you do?
I'm not exactly sure, but I see old Bullfrog got his progress shirt on. Guess he likes a bit of that
yeah,
British wrestling.
Yeah, go to your corner, go to your corner.
But still, I gotta ask, what side do you think is gonna have the handicap?
I mean, usually, well, I think Froggy's gonna have the handicap against him. Cause it's supposed to be Juicy.
Yep, I think we know it. Here come the sirens. Bobby Juicy Field over there. He seems excited about this match. Like, this is the closest thing he's gonna get to facing the world champion.
But he is facing the world champion.
Well, I mean, this isn't a world title match, obviously. I mean, Bobby Juicy Field wouldn't be that crazy to book himself in a world title match, right? Right?
Hey, hang on, sorry, what was that? Sorry, I had to go mute there for a second.
Yep. I wouldn't be surprised if Bobby Juicy Field would book himself for a world title match, right?
I mean, he's gotta earn it. Like, you can't just be free willing to just give yourself a title shot.
I mean, there's been a fair few times where he's booked himself in title matches, but for a world title match? Could he do it?
Nah, that's too crazy. Too crazy. Well, who's his partner?
Yeah, that's what I'm wondering. Well, here comes the pain! What indeed?
Well, Froggy meet the beast, Brock Lesnar!
The alpha male of our species has arrived. Whoa!
And from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 295 pounds, Brock Lesnar!
Brock Lesnar looks in a destructive mood tonight. I think it's one of those nights where Brock does not give a fuck.
I mean, Brock Lesnar's in the Rumble, so you gotta think. This could be an example of what Brock Lesnar could win if he wins the Rumble and gets the face or bullfrog potentially at Mania.
Well, he's currently number 30, so I mean, you all like them odds, ladies and gentlemen.
I mean, I believe Brock Lesnar has won a Rumble at the number 30 position before, so if he's done it once, he could do it again.
For the love of God.
We're just gonna have to wait and see, folks, but this is not going to go well with this matchup. And thank good it's not one on three, at least it's just one on two. Right,
I'll be back in a second chat. My DoorDasher is literally just arriving now.
No worries. As Brock getting a punch, is it a Jersey Field joint again? The bullfrog with a reversal, but Brock Lesnar just stomps him. And both heads just landing into each other. Oh, bullfrog over here. He's going to lay into everything. As this crowd's chanting at this point, run, Froggy, run. He better be running at this point, because this is overpoweringly the odds. He has to overcome the odds here, because Bobby Juicy Field throws him over and goes for the cover here. One, two, only a two. Oh my God, this is concerning. Oh my God, picks up. Oh my God, just laying it right on the neck area. And wait a minute, Brock Lesnar going up top. What are you thinking, Brock? What are you thinking? This is too dangerous. No, no, no! Axe handle! Top rope axe handle. I'm telling you, Brock Lesnar and Bobby Juicy Field, they are a force to be reckoned with in this contest. And immediately, Froggy just having to leap. He's got to do anything. In order to beat these two. Realistically, that's what he's gonna be praying for and hoping for, to get some kind of offense in. And oh no, Juicy Field picking up, sitting in the corner. Oh! Right into the corner of the ring post as Bobby Juicy Field just goes straight for that head area there on Froggy and goes to the cover. But only a one. Only a one, thank goodness. And Brock just getting him into something, but impressively going there. What do you think Bullfrog has to do to pull off against these two? Honestly, Bullfrog needs to find some kind of way to take out these two men. As Brock, not again! He just goes for a splash. But Bullfrog, he knows a thing or two about splashes. And he just takes out Brock. He needs to take care of these guys one at a time. Bullfrog needs to be thinking about using the announce table even. Like there's an announce table there he can use as a weapon. Like he needs to throw one of these two into that announce table in order to even get a chance of beating these guys. As Bullfrog hits Brock Lesnar with a spear. And Bullfrog going up there. He's going to have to pray. He is going to have to do everything. He's going to have to do something. Got to keep them grounded. That's really the only way. Exactly. You got to keep them grounded. But you also kind of need to deal with them like one at a time. Like throw one of them through the table. And the other deal with them next. Like you got to do something. Bullfrog needs to knock one of them out. Exactly. He needs to do it. He needs to knock someone's ass out. Too much. Good God, the odds are just too much. As we can see, just the odds. They are undeniable. The double choke slam. One, two. Oh, still alive. Still alive in there, old Bullfrog. He is still fighting.
Just walk out the bloody ring, Froggy. It's not worth it. Oh, God. Oh, my God.
Oh, right onto the floor. I'm telling you, Bullfrog needs to deal with these guys. I was saying Bullfrog needs to throw the opponent into the announce table. You need
Hang
to
on,
do
chat.
Something. The Froggy's surviving. That's true. Froggy is surviving here, but for how long? That's the question with the suplex from Brock. And, oh my god, that is a very familiar looking move. But with a little bit of a different flair. I've never seen someone doing that move roll over and jump to it. Oh my god, the suplex from Juicy Field. I'm telling you, Bobby Juicy Field is just too damn strong. And Brock Lesnar, he looks like he's getting the steel steps, but from what I know, this match does have disqualifications, so bad idea to use the steel steps in this case. And Froggy Destroyer! Oh my god, the Froggy Destroyer! Bullfrog laying it in. I think he's taking out Bobby Juicy Field for the time being. Now Brock Lesnar's just laying into him. Oh god, Brock Lesnar and Dom, we just been, wait a minute, roll up, roll up! One. Oh, the fruit roll up didn't work out. I think this sounds like a great flavor of fruit roll ups. Wait a minute, Walls of Fruit has been applied. Will he tap? No. As Bobby Juicy Field breaks it up. And Bobby Juicy Field, oh, the suplex of his own. And wait a minute, Bobby Juicy Field, what is he doing? Bobby, oh my god. Speaking of splashes, Bobby Juicy Field just made a splash. This is very much some meat here. I mean, we're dealing with three big men in this contest, so you have to
Hi, Canadian.
You have to think with this meat that it's gonna be a brutal here. Already it was brutal. Froggy just needs to get pinned so he doesn't get injured. I don't know if that's gonna help at this time, mate. I don't know. As Brock Lesnar just lays into him here. And Brock picking up, he's gonna powerbomb him right by the corner! Good lord, it almost looked like he landed his head on one of the turnbuckles there, I think. And wait a minute, Bobby Juicy Field, what the hell is he doing? Jesus! Juicy Field doing? He's leaping. What the hell is it Bobby Juicy Field tonight? He's acting like a cruiserweight. Even though he's a super heavyweight. I don't know how he's doing it. I don't know how he's even doing it, but Brock Lesnar just drops him right by the neck area. Look at Brock Lesnar just laying it there in the Froggy. Oh no, he's picked him up. It looks like it's F5 time. Wait a minute, no! Oh my god! I think Froggy's just been busted open, guys. Froggy is bleeding. Froggy is bleeding. Good lord, that is not gonna help at all. I think. Man, I don't know if Froggy's okay here. Froggy is bleeding. They are just manhandling him. Yeah. I'd be wondering, if Froggy can't get up at this point, they might have to vacate the belt. Like, oh lord, but this is not going to go well. Bobby Juicy Field. What is he doing? Going right for the arm here. Trying to break Froggy's arm. Froggy fighting back. Good lord, Froggy's just gonna fight back. He's fighting hard. That's the only thing he can do at this point. They are just too strong as... Oh! God! I think he just destroyed his ribs. I think Froggy's ribs might be broken. Bullfrog's getting up. Oh my god! And Froggy just takes him down with that very familiar movement. Oh my god! Froggy! This might be what he has to do! This might be what he has to do! He's gonna have to use the announce table! That's what Froggy might have to do! He might have to throw someone into that table!
We're checking here. We're at two. And look at Froggy. Froggy is hyped. Froggy is
Froggy,
ready to
for
go.
The love of God, just walk out. Just walk away, mate.
At this point, Froggy has just got so much oh my god, he picked up the step. He was trying to get himself disqualified there. He picked up the steps. It looked like he wanted to go for disqualification, even though he lost the match.
And Brock just back out.
How do you feel about this? This is gruesome.
This is hard to watch. Oh, Froggy, wait a minute.
Oh my god. Bobby Jizzyfield's still getting up. Froggy's still getting up and Lesnar's still getting up. Like, if you're Froggy, this is hell on earth for you. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if he gets too injured to compete and he's gonna have to vacate the belt.
Little leg, that's gonna be it.
Two.
Oh my
Stay
god.
Stay down. Damn it.
Froggy just kicked him out. And Brock, what is he doing? No way. What the? Froggy just reversed Brock away from his dive.
Dive.
Brock Lesnar doing dives. Oh.
Hate the WWE fall of Brock Roman as the modern day Rock Austin. When it really became the modern Austin. I like that. Oh, that's been a death. I like that a lot. How you doing well anyway, Heavy Metal?
You'll be doing well there, Metal. And you're seeing, quite honestly, a brutal war.
At this point, Froggy just keeps getting up, even though at this point, his
ribs
must be broken.
Oh, God, now Juicy. Juicy.
God, Lord, Bobby Juicyfield, what is he doing?
Oh!
God! I think Froggy's ribs might be broken, man. I 100% believe his ribs are broken.
What's the meaning behind this, though? Like, why would you want to be... Why do this?
That's my question. I mean, Froggy is the face of the company at this point.
Well,
I mean,
showing stereotypes. Google search it.
Yeah. Google it, man. But, I mean, is it revenge from the YVB? I mean, we know Bobby Juicyfield's a member of the YVB. And we know BK lost his belt to Froggy, so...
Brock Lesnar, icing. Nice.
Oh, reversal there.
Oh.
Although, duplex from Juicyfield.
And Brock, let's show how it's done.
Oh, God. Second suplex goes to the third. Can he get it? And he does. Bobby Juicyfield going right
for
the
cover. Oh, Bobby would take the bloody pin here.
Going for the cover. One,
and
two.
It is finally over.
You gotta feel bad for Froggy for this. I think he might be injured, man. I think Bobby Juicyfield and Brock Lesnar just injured Bullfrog. This is hard to watch, folks. But this really is. Man, Bobby Juicyfield is somehow still the general manager, and he's abusing his power like this. Like, Lord.
Nah, that was not right. That was just not right. That was not right at all. All right. Intercontinental Tournament, round two, match one. starting now. Supreme Echo overcame the Icon Steven Page and Yamashita beat Botch to advance to this match here tonight.
Oh, this is gonna be good, folks. I mean, these two men, they are some of the best on this roster. Can they get the job done? We're gonna find out. I think now's a good time for me to pull out my bubbly here. All that smell, that... I've got myself some Bilson's creaming. The thing is supposed to be like creaming soda. Good lord, the pyro.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Orlando, Florida, weighing in at 230 pounds. Four.
Well, here's Echo. And
Jesus Christ.
My god, it makes MGB's pyro look like bloody Axiom's. Even though Axiom doesn't have pyro.
Do you think WWE will have Brock and Sheldon reunite in a tag match before this leaves the company? Well, Sheldon's been released. Sheldon got released last year in that batch heavy metal, so unless they bring Sheldon Benjamin back into the company, I don't think so.
Yeah. I wouldn't be surprised if Shelton goes to TNA. Like, I wouldn't be surprised. But, well, speaking of someone who has a lot of fire, well, this man likes to bring out the fire.
I mean, this man is on double duty tonight because he's got to defend that TV title as well tonight.
Oh boy, that's gonna make things a lot harder for this man. The
tonight's bubbly is tonight's. IC Tournament is not sponsored by you, Cola.
Oh, a bit of cue.
You'll always be first in line when you have some cue. Good night.
Yeah. Oh, man. Well, like, tonight I've got myself some Bilson's Creamy, which apparently is supposed to taste
Sting
like
Sting
and
Ultimo reunited, but the match was not good. Ooh. Yeah, Sheldon's one of those that got released along with Ziggler and that, so... Q! No direct affiliation with TCW or Captain Quark.
Okay. I haven't had this Bilson's Creamy before, and you know what? It's pretty alright. Like, I don't know. It doesn't fully taste like creaming soda to me, but.
All I'm hearing all right, from you right now is mine.
I ain't like that Wingo.
Mine.
I ain't like him.
Mine. Oh, Morris WCW run was a disaster. Ooh, yeah.
Yep, that was terrible. But man, Supreme Echo, he's having some terrible luck here against Yamashita. Oh, but he reverses.
Now the winner will advance to the final next week.
I mean, one of these two men, they could do it. They could potentially.
Oh, bear hug!
Your next TV champ. It's Yamashita with the bear hug.
I say champ, not TV champ.
Yes. Oh yeah. Does Craig think I'm that bloody woodpecker guy? He talks a lot.
I know. You're like best mates with him. Royal Rumble champion to be a good one. Yes, it is.
Oh, I'm excited for the Rumble.
Let's be honest. Jinder Mahal, the next World Heavyweight Championship next week. At this point, made the TV title 24/7 title. I mean, it's like 95% defended each episode. 95%. 5% usually means I forgot to put it on the card. Oops.
Damn it. Oh, going right for the punch here. And the kicks here from Echo. Wait a minute, what's Echo thinking?
Oh, a power bomb there from Supreme Echo. All five is carry, and a Samoan drop, sort of?
That's a bit different.
Oh, send the corner. At this point, make it defended at name redacted. There's no point defending on name redacted. Because it's just a friggin' YouTube show now.
Name redacted. I thought you were referring to what culture? Oh wait, Defiant closed down years ago.
Two wrestlers that grew up in that grew out of with Batista and Lex Luger. Lex Luger's an interesting choice, tell me more. We should have a TSM hardcore title, be cool to see. Oh god.
Oh, we got a submission here. Going for a chokehold here.
Yeah, Machida.
Reversal.
Just, eh.
I mean, look, a hardcore title would be cool, but there's already a fair few belts, so.
Yeah, that's the thing. We've got enough belts already running around here, ladies and gentlemen. You know, we've only got a certain amount of TV time each week we can sort of go for. So, yeah. Lex Luger in WCW was one of the best US champions, and his world title win against Hogan was a classic moment. Fair enough. Remember when Fight introduced 24/7 title? Yep, that was a mistake.
Yeah, especially when Mick Foley was like, oh hey, the third hour of Raw,
Stutter!
Let's just change the colouring.
I mean, let's be honest, the only good thing about the 24/7 title is Kelly was a 24/7 champion.
K-24/7. The funniest moment, the Medusa trying to throw it in the bin again.
Oh yeah, insane. Sounds like the word for it. Stupid is the word for it.
And look at Yamashita.
Yeah, better world title win on Nitro when Goldberg made Hayne. Yeah.
Yeah, that was a classic moment.
I mean, there's still one that tops even that. Poke.
Oh, yeah. In fact, just a few days ago, I think the Finger Poke of Doom celebrated an anniversary.
Yeah, it did. The only good thing that came out of those famous between R-Truth and Drake Maverick.
That was brilliant.
I need to get a Drake Maverick award, point award. Oh wait, Yamashita!
Oh, slams him down!
That could be over! Yamashita advances to the final of the IC tournament.
Could we be seeing a double champion sooner rather than later?
Well, he's got to defend his TV title yet, so he might have just jinxed him.
Well, who knows?
Here is your winner, Yamashita.
I mean, look, anything's possible here in TCW. But still, Yamashita making it through to the next round. You gotta think, he's probably the favorite to win it.
You'd like to see an Undisputed Women's Championship in TCW?
Exactly.
In TCW. We've got too many women for that. Once upon a time, there was just the one women's champion. But nowadays, because of all the women and, you know, pretty much because the only most important women are the members of the YVA. I mean, all our women are very equally treated in TCW. Yeah. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, God, what the fuck?
You right, man?
Yeah, just a little tired, but we're gonna just push through this. I'll probably actually take probably tomorrow off. You called Lox a Girl Scout. Who else dresses like that? A Girl Scout! tastes like it.
You don't see Lux handing out boxes of Thin Mints.
Shivani spared the first to send the finger poker Doom, who turned from Dark Shadow Rossi following the world title. Said the pitch would win that one too. Alrighty, our last semi-final in the IC tournament. So this will be deciding who Yamashita's opponent is next week on Surge. It's going to be between Faded and Denny Ortiz. Of course, Faded put away top of the buns. And Ortiz shocked Gronk.
I gotta tell you, this is an interesting match. Could go any way here. Just gonna have to wait and see. Man, sold out crowd tonight here.
Don't make me put into a Girl Scout uniform. You know I will.
Hard and thirsty to big cold beer.
Oh. Oh.
The best cold beer.
Oh. Oh. Hang on a minute. Hard and thirst. Harder first, there's a big cold Q. And the best cold there is Q. You need to see more of Vader's WCW stuff?
Vader was like the GOAT in WCW. Like, he was great there. Like, he straight up was.
Ooh.
I mean, his WWE run, it didn't go too well for him. WCW.
No worries, Faye. Take your time, mate. We're only here, you know, for a couple of times now.
Faye thinks he's the Undertaker over here.
The main issue, I can't even access my freaking 2K23. What do you mean? What issue? Did you get banned? What'd you do?
Oh boy, what happened there? Is it something with the PSN or Xbox Live or Steam?
Can't update because you have no internet. Yeah, that'd do it.
Oh. Wouldn't you be able to do like mobile hotspot directly to the console?
Sorry. You'd lose all your data fucking quickly. Vader versus Third Starcade.
That would actually probably be a good match to watch.
Alright, hey, I'm gonna splash some water on my face, wipe myself up a bit. And chuck this.
I'm all distressed, mate.
Can't do it. You got banned on 2K22. Okay, alright, back in his head. All tests will take 5 minutes to get to the ring anyway, let's be honest.
Yeah, he'll take a bit. He'll take a bit. It was terrible when he came back in the 2000s Vader. Oh man. I mean, I remember one time where he's like teaming up with Jonathan Coachman for some reason. I mean, look, Jonathan Coachman's fine, but you don't need to put Vader with him. Like, seriously, you don't need Vader to be with the coach, okay? You just don't. Like, look at it, you just don't need Vader with the coach. Why did the two people with one of the longest entrances fight? I have no clue, but they did earn their spot here, so very much, they're ready to go. But here we go, these guys are ready for it. They're about to fight. Coachman was terrible on so many levels. Ah, yeah. I mean, look, Coachman was a decent commentator as such. I mean, even his 2018 run was all right, but yeah, in other aspects, he just didn't go too well for him. It just didn't go well. As, oh,
I believe Faded's getting the punches in on Ortiz and all going for the submission. Okay. Okay. I need to see Ryback again. He's on TikTok, mate. If you want to see him, go to your TikToks. He's just laying it with those strikes here. I need to see that Vader match against Stan Hansen, where Stan punched Vader so hard in the face, his eyeball. Oh God, that sounds horrifying. That sounds terrifying, man. Remember Todd Grisham? He was a good backstage interviewer. I think he was also a commentator at one point. I remember him doing commentary on SmackDown. From what I remember, but... Oh, wait a minute. Oh! Just going right for it there with that head. Well, that's striking there, but... Oh, picks him up, drops him down. And you know what I think? For Daniel Ortiz are faded, yeah. This is the biggest opportunity you can get here. I mean, being able to win the Intercontinental Championship, like... It's one of those titles that these men have never really held, so... Very much, if you can win it, maybe we'll take it! As the elbow drop has been missed. And hello, hello then, NASCAR 97 fan. Oh, powerbomb! We got a cover here. One. Only one. Just only a one here. As we can see, they just gone.
Who
back
the fuck wants to see Cry back again? Okay, wait, hold on. Why do you want to see Cryback? Hello, Jonah. Coachman was terrible on so many levels. Yep. Remember Todd Grishmi was a good backstage interviewer? Meh. Yeah. He was meh. Remember Matt Stryker? Fuck it, no. Matt Stryker, I actually... enjoyed Matt Stryker on commentary.
Even in WCPW when he did those shows occasionally?
Only WWE Matt Stryker commentary. I haven't seen WCPW stuff.
Yeah. I mean, then again, WCPW was like the indie that kind of went mainstream in a way because like it mainstreamed a lot of talent. So, yeah, but.
Yeah, no, doing good, Jonah. How are you, man? You want to see Ryback really badly. You want to see Heath Slater again. I'll take Heath Slater over Ryback any day.
I mean, if you want to see Ryback, just go to your TikToks. That's it. Just go to TikTok. He's
oh,
there.
Wait a minute. Faded.
Okay, we're coming. One, two.
Only two there.
Not quite. Ryback is the male Nia Jax. Good lord. And he's just laying it in.
Put it this way. Yeah. I'd rather Brad Maddox than Ryback. And that says that because Brad Maddox is a piece of shit himself.
I think one time he called the crowd, what was it, cocky pricks?
Yeah, that's what he got fired for. He called them pricks.
Even though that's kind of like a PG insult?
Yeah.
I mean, hey, at least he didn't call them cocky fucks. Or dickweeds. At least he didn't call
them that. What do we really remember Brad Maddox for? Him as a general manager?
That one time where he screwed up the refereeing?
That, or... being involved in that thing. Right, Ortiz.
One, two.
Has to kick out. What do you really remember Brad Maddox for?
I don't think I was really watching when Brad Maddox was a thing,
right,
to be honest.
Faded. One, off that 630, and he does it!
Faded has done it!
So we're going to get Faded versus Yamashita next week, and the winner gets the IC title shot at the pay-per-view, at the premium live preview.
the Twitch purview, if you prefer. I'm definitely down to see it. Faded versus Yamashita, that is gonna slap!
Here is your winner,
Stoney. Rather have Vicky Guerrero come back than Ryback, yeah.
Wasn't Vicky on AEW for a bit?
Yeah, but then she had some, shit. Yeah, some very disturbing shit went down with Vicky.
Still, though, what a match there. Like, that was pretty solid. Seriously, you look at Mad Dog's face right now, he's just like, rah. He's like that one Finn Balor meme. Right?
Now, what? That was Junior. Bad Junior.
There we go.
Oh, Junior, when will you ever learn?
Alrighty.
Well, so far, this has been a pretty damn solid show.
Alright. Fuck, we're already an hour into the show. What the hell? Junior, stop! My hands were up here. It wasn't me, it was Junior. Alright, anyway. Coming up next, John Montana goes 1-on-1 against King Paragon. Let's go down to the ring.
We are expecting some cruiserweight action here. This is gonna be good.
Since when has John Montana been a fucking cruiserweight?
I mean, he definitely shares some aspects of the cruiserweight style.
Junior, get down!
Hey, Junior, what are you doing, man?
Junior, come on, no, come on, go.
Junior, do you need me to DoorDash you some honey or something?
Look, just. Here, play with an empty bottle. Pretend you're a Chef Stanley. Do a whole feast or something. I don't care.
Well, he's John Montana. He's ready to fight.
It's scheduled for 1 fall. Making his way to the ring, representing the Eliminators from Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Weighing in at 235 pounds, the Assassin John Montana.
I mean, you gotta say, for a member of the future, he has been one hell of a presence throughout the last year.
So I'm going to be a bit in and out of this match. I'm just trying to get some work stuff organized here. They've given me fucking five jobs tomorrow. And the first one's
Jesus
fucking four Christ chairs. And they want me to do four chairs in 90 minutes. Like, no thank you.
Four of them in 90 minutes? Good God almighty.
Good thing is I'm by myself though. No fucking babysitting.
Well, I think it's time for some Lucha style.
Chihuahua, Mexico, weighing in at 158 pounds, King Paragon.
Oh, and here comes that big old leap. Always nails it. Always does.
Oh, that's cool, Steph.
One of these days, I need to do an order on WWE Shop. One of these days. Gotta figure out if they do PayPal Pay in 4 or something. Oh, there we go. It's Paragon. Gets him up, and you spin me right round, baby, right round, like a record, baby, right round, round, round.
Really?
I always do that.
Not to that extent. Penroyce!
He just flips him over. He takes him down there. Oh, going back one to WWE. No hesitation.
Oh. Baby, you know it.
Who are you thinking?
For what?
For that request.
Payton!
Ah, Payton. Oh.
Sin Cara. What? Bro, Sin Cara is Spanish for you're eliminated.
You know what? I'd say Matt Cardona, but as the Matt Cardona gimmick, I mean, we need the indie god on the main roster. It's just perfect.
You've been hanging around bloody Zach Murphy, haven't you?
Well, hey, you don't need to bring in Steph. You just need to bring in Chelsea as the manager. Oh, one, two. Oh, not quite. Not quite enough there for Montana. Of Chris Masters. Which Chris Masters we talking about?
The masterpiece.
Ah, nice. Yeah, you don't want to get your masters confused. This don't here. How about Rey Mysterio 619 and Biggest Little Man DVD case? I want to see more of his ECW stuff. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Is it a documentary on Binge or something? Like, I'm not sure.
That'd be pretty cool, though. Especially like a lot of his WCW stuff, too.
Yeah. And
oh!
Good lord, Montana's just soaring through the sky. Man. Feels sad knowing that we're not going to get WWE DVDs anymore. Like, since they're no longer doing them.
Go back.
Oh, just goes right out of there. Paragon. And Paragon throws him. Oh, didn't quite throw the way he wanted to as he gets suplexed. I'm telling you, I legit would love. I kind of want to import the Mania 39 Blu-ray. That's like the last Mania to be released on Blu-ray. I kind of want to. I think somewhere had it with Stand and Deliver on DVD or something. I can't remember. I'll check. But oh, Paragon doing pretty good there. Oh, this is risky. This is risky. Paragon going on the outside. Wait a minute, Paragon. Oh my god. Paragon resetting the count. Either Sin Cara or The Fiend or Daniel Bryan. Well, The Fiend would have to be recast then if you want to bring that back. You would have to recast it because, well, obviously, Wyndham's gone, but I mean, I'd be happy to see Bryan Danielson back. Like, it would be cool. I mean, I don't expect it, but it would be cool. All the strikes coming on in there. And John Montana. Montana back in the ring. He's trying to get that count out win here. Oh, no. He does not. He resets that count. There's that good old reset. Paragon back at it again. A lot of Kakuna. Yeah, no, I'm not going to take that. Daniel Bryan has one of the most iconic catchphrases. Oh, yeah. The yes chant is iconic. Bro, what's Swerve's manager? He's so funny. I forgot his name.
Prince Nana. Yeah, Prince Nana. He's the guy who does like the dance at the top of his entrance. He's great. He's great. And
Montana? Going right back way. Oh, spear! Montana with the spear! Just going right for the ribs. One, two. Oh, not quite.
I'm telling you, this is what Surge is all about, folks. Incredible action every damn week.
I swerve when I drive. I swerve when I drive.
So, yeah. And wait a minute. You spin me right round, baby, right round. Look, Rebecca, baby, right round, round, round.
Well, this is insane. I wouldn't mind Stacy winning a title in 2024. She never had a chance.
Stacy Heber? Is she still wrestling? Oh, well, Paragon. Paragon might take it here. One, two. Oh, not quite. Not quite there for... Oh, Paragon. So you've got me here, his commentary partner there. Oh, popping.
Hang on. I'm here.
Yep, there he is.
Hello, chat. Servinator, thanks for the raid, mate. Servinator knows what is up. Triple H's best fate. Better than the game. Better than King of Kings. My man.
My time, definitely a classic.
It's not a classic. It is the classic.
They should put it on vinyl. Like, they should do like a proper vinyl record of WWE things and put it on there.
Why? So you can go spin my record, babe, right round, like a record, round.
I mean...
welcome out, everyone. I'm Mad Dog. This is TCW Twitch Community Wrestling.
And this is Surge.
And you're in the Montana's told the ref to count faster here. Paragon. Paragon's not going to make it. And Montana's going to take a count out. What a disappointment.
Definitely disappointing for Paragon there, but wow, what a match.
Hey, what have I missed here in chat? Once again, 7-8, thanks for the follow, mate. Stacy winning a title in 2024. She never had a chance. Right, let Stacy win the title. I'll take that. Thanks for the follow. It's your boy Pans and Servinator. My friend asked. What? My friend asked me if your haircut for deaf person is that taking their right of speech. What?
Ooh. Yeah, that would be rough.
I don't know how to answer that. Would that be taking their rights? Here's my introduction to wrestling with Mother's Bret Hart. One Chris Jericho.
I can't remember for sure because it's been so long. I think maybe it might have been.
Yes, you got the name right. Sounds an unread name. That's pretty easy to pronounce. It's your boy Pans. That's an easy one.
It's a pretty good name.
Now, would they still talk? They're not mute. I told her I'll ask my deaf brother. Oh my god. Okay. Hey, that. Clap. Clap for that. AJ Styles is Mike. Is Mike his favorite? Hell yeah.
Ooh. I mean, Styles is great. Like, he is.
Alrighty.
Seriously, though, we need to bring back the Evil Ways fam. Like, that was so good.
They called me Moat. It's Pears or your boy, not Motor. That's what I mean. Like I want somebody to say, like, the whole name, but I'd be like, you know, it's your boy, Pans, like, or just be like, hey, Pans, how are ya? You know, who remembers Sin Cara? Oh, my God. Was before these Sin Cara marks coming out? Are you all? Oh, my God. Sin Cara gonna go in the, oh, my God. Sin Cara shows up in the Rumble. Oh, my God. Oh, no.
Are you guys, like, that Sin Cara versus Sin Cara storyline or something?
At the dinner table, my brother and deaf girlfriend were talking to each other, and my dad said, don't talk with your mouth full. Oh my fucking God. Oh shit. Alright, let's move on to our next match here, ladies and gentlemen. Matt Riddle is the GOAT.
In ring rise? You could say that, in ring rise. Outside of the ring.
You got into Sin Cara face to a Scooby Doo. What the? Really, Scooby Doo?
Is that one? That's maybe a mystery or some shit. God.
TJP, yeah.
You just reminded
me
that existed.
Yeah, I remember TJP.
TJP was great.
I was literally, what was it? I literally was watching something last night, and TJ was actually in the. Tony Nese is in the.
Was it TNA or New Japan?
Oh, so I can't remember now. Why get fired though? I'm assuming wasn't he just part of the fucking
releases? Yeah.
Yeah. It's just part of those big releases. Anyway, we'll keep going on. Hello, Caden. Who do you think will win, Roman or Prime Randy? Ooh.
Prime Randy. Like, Orton is Prime was goat tier.
That's a hard one. Matt Riddle's, he's signed to some promotion. He also showed up to challenge, what's his name?
Hiroshi Tanahashi.
That's it, yes.
Yeah, so I think Matt Riddle's in MLW.
Yeah, that's it, MLW. And yeah, he's challenging, Tanahashi for the, what's it, TV title or something?
Yeah, I think the New Japan World Television title or some shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think Matt Riddle was on the last MLW show wrestling Jacob Fatu.
Let's see. He was fought or something is what I'm hearing. Let's have a quick look at this. And then we'll get into our next match here.
Hello, Caden.
Disciplinary reasons? Hang on.
I mean, yeah, you were saying discipline sort of thing, and the song was saying discipline. How the hell did I notice that?
Yeah, that's weird. Come on, let's get this while we're still talking. So, Delta, JGB, let's get out of the ring. Stone Cold became your favorite wrestler after Brett went to WCW.
What?
So Cena also stopped the rolling ball while his theme song was playing. Unfortunately, I do remember that. All of Randy's goat here. I mean, Prime Randy. Prime Randy maybe could just steal away the win. Who would win, Strowman or Prime Big Show? Prime Big Show.
Yeah, especially Big Show when he could do the like the top rope stuff or something.
Oh yes.
Like WCW era Big Show.
The Giant.
Yeah. Well, we've got Delta coming on.
Here's one for you. Prime Stone Cold Steve Austin versus Prime Cena.
Ooh. I think Prime Stone Cold. Like, he just... That era Stone Cold, he was like the GOAT. Prime Andre or Prime Yokozuna.
Yokozuna. Andre. It was very limited. And the guy was a drunk all the time anyway.
Like, he drank like, what was it, 15 bottles of wine or some shit? 15 cans or something at once?
Yeah, something like that. The man liked his wine. Anyway, speaking like fine wine, here's Delta.
Yeah, Delta. I don't expect him to do much flips here, but he'll definitely go for some fists. As he takes on this man, representing the Golden Boys, JGB.
Austin is top three, Cena is top 10.
And his opponent, representing the good guys.
Back when wrestlers were allowed to drink before their matches, yep. I don't drink 50 beers at the pub with Juicy.
I mean, I heard it somewhere. Probably from old Woodpecker. He probably told me.
Can Trav even drink beer yet? Alright, who else? Let's see here.
JGB has got a lot of pyro.
So who else would be a good one? Prime Edge versus Stone Cold all the way. Stone Cold all the way.
Like, yeah, I give it to Edge. Like, Prime Edge, he was really fucking good.
Alright, here's one. Prime Bryan Danielson versus Prime Bret the Hitman Hart.
I think I'm gonna have to give it to Danielson. Like, look, Hart was great, but I think I'm just gonna have to give it to Danielson.
We got a lot of love here for Bret Hart.
Yeah.
Then you'd be wrong.
Oh my god. I just had a good one. Prime Kenny Omega versus Prime Finn Balor.
Kenny.
Think so?
Bret was Bryan Danielson before there was a Bryan Danielson. Exactly, Mikey. Yeah, give me an argument on why Finn Balor then. Tyler?
I mean, Finn's one of I think Finn is one of those guys who has really been, like, one of the best out there. He has that perfect style to him, that perfect mix of, like, sort of cruiserweights we know and love, but also that hard-hitting. So, he's kind of like that perfect sort of main event level guy. I mean, we can even see it nowadays.
Prime Undertaker versus Prime Big Show. Undertaker by far.
Yeah, I'll give it Taker.
We had a good Prime Kane match. Fuck, a good Prime Kane match. Fuck, a good Kane match.
I think a decent one was that one with Stone Cold in the cell. Like, that was alright, wasn't it?
Trying to think. Prime Kane versus Prime Kevin Nash.
Kane. I give it to Kane.
Yeah, I'd probably give it to Kane too myself.
Well, as we can see here, Delta. Ooh, DDT.
Stone Cold's best match was always against Triple H. What? I said that man's name is Triple H. What?
He said that name is Triple H, what?
Shut up, JR.
I'm trying to do my job here. Oh, Biggles.
Recovery by JGB.
One, two.
You would say Earl Cole. I'm sorry, you would say Kevin Nash just used his entrance. Prime Kane. Because, look, Kevin Nash should be 5 minutes into a match, tear his quad. Or blow out his knee. He injured himself so easy.
Could be worse. It could be like one of those old gimmicks like fucking Oz or Vinny Vegas. As well, JGB hoping he's not Vinny Vegas here. Going for the guillotine choke.
Second time this match. He's really reefing here. Delta. Delta can just shift his body weight and put JGB in a pretty predicament.
But JGB trying to make Delta go to the City of Oz with that choke, but
Delta couldn't hold the move, though. Ah!
Powerbomb.
Face first.
Reverse raises edge. Sharpshooter.
What?
Is that what he's
doing? JGB tapped! Look more like an inverted cloverleaf.
Yeah, I'm not sure. It looked like he was going for the sharpshooter there for a second. But still, a win's a win here for Delta.
JGB had a lot of momentum in this match here, but this is where the finish was.
As he hits like a reverse razor's edge there. And then he gets into the submission.
Almost tries to go into a line tamer.
I thought he looked like he was going to the sharpshooter.
Here is your winner. Rock and Austin were the best of the Attitude Era. Yeah, 100%. Rock and Austin, the best sales of the stunner, absolutely.
Yeah.
You put Shane McMahon in that list too. As sellers to the Stone Cold Stunner, son, what?
Yeah, you know, I gotta say, I think I liked Austin Theory sell a bit. That was a good one.
Lucky you think that says, because I thought you were just about to say you like Austin Theory. I was about to spit my drink out.
Theory's fine. Nothing special.
You think you're special. Alrighty. We have a tag title opportunity here. Coming up, ladies and gentlemen, because it is the team of Earl Cult teaming up with Trav to take on the Blood Pact. And if they can beat the Blood Pact, they will earn themselves a TCW Tag Team title opportunity. Big thanks here.
This looks to be a championship contenders match here. So very much, if you can beat the champs, you get yourself an opportunity at some gold.
They can do it. If they can do it once, they can do it twice. Let's get out of the ring. Cool.
Oh, man. What an interesting lineup of competitors here in this contest.
Yeah!
Yeah? Huh? Oh!
Tag team match set for one fall. Introducing first, representing the good guys from Melbourne, Australia, weighing in at 121 pounds. Dangerous One, Travis.
You gotta admit, Travis definitely gained himself a new attitude lately. And this is definitely proving it.
There he is, Trav!
He has definitely got that new look, that new
all
feel.
Right. With Evan T-R-A-V, yeah!
Yeah! I mean, what do you think of Trav's new attitude?
Oh, I think he's a bit more cocky, to be honest. But his taunt against the old wing girl always funny to look at.
I mean, hey. He is definitely taunting him real good. But he's got one hell of a partner here.
And his partner from Houston, Texas, weighing in at 120 pounds, the Outlaw, Earl Colt.
Well, it looks like it's time for some cowboy shit.
Wrong game. Alrighty. Well, Cole, a former TCW Intercontinental Champion, looking to maybe get himself some tag team gold here.
Colt's one of those guys that you can see winning gold anytime he's in the ring. And I said, you could see him doing it.
Okay. I mean, it's no longer Elias, it's Elijah. But anyway, for these two to get a tag title shot, they have to beat these men.
The Wolf Pack's most dangerous representatives, the Blood Pact.
What? What?
Yeah. I said it. You do not want to mess with these two men.
What?
You just don't want to mess with old Nova Adams and Marcus Mathias.
Oh boy, you and Nova Beck has been buds now, are ya?
I mean, Nova's one of those guys. You just, in general, you don't want to mess with him. In general. I mean, they are the champs, too.
Don't
forget that.
You've got Marcus Mathias trying to do his best Rodney Mac impersonation. And then next to him, you've got Wish.com version of Red.
Oh, Lord. Well, Trav, about to make him spinning daisy. Trav representing the Golden Boys. Throwing him into the corner there. As he tags into Earl Colt. Looking to go all bang bang. Oh! That'll definitely stun him.
Cover
here.
One.
Alright. If Nova loses to a one-eyed cowboy, that would be embarrassing. Does he have one eye? I mean, he's wearing a mask. Well, it's hard to tell since he's wearing the face coverings and such.
He's probably doing a Kakashi.
Oh,
Oh, he's striking all Nova. What's he thinking? Going for the strike. Of course, Marcus Mathias, a former world champion here. Definitely one of those guys who has
the
that
infamous
experience.
30-second champ. Figure, so I went to a bloody Tony Chimble there for a second. Yeah, super!
30-second? I thought it was more like 30 minutes.
He won the belt and got cashed in on.
Well, he had a match in between. You do forget that. As he go, as I'll cope with the fingers.
Tag to Trav.
That's what we gotta do. Frequent tags! Well, that's what they're hoping for with the frequent tags. Trav, what's he looking for here? Oh, Colt with the strike. L loves breaking fingers. Well, apparently he does, but I think that might have been a big mistake there from Trav. Ooh. Good Lord, I mean, that veteran experience.
That was smart there by Trav, breaking, like, you know, cutting off the ring there.
Yeah. So again, got very close to it.
Two wrestling greats that don't have DVDs. Rick Rude and Booker T. Really? Booker's don't have a DVD yet? There's no way.
Booker must have had a DVD, right? Especially when he came back in like 2011. You think he would? With Booker. Now it just reminds me how sad it is they're not doing the DVDs anymore.
No, there's a best of Booker DVD.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, obviously,
well, Booker T the early years.
Yeah. You know, now I'm reminded I should import the WrestleMania 39 Blu-ray.
I had talking about that
movie.
Earlier. Tag to Nova.
I mean, yes, I know you can get it on binge and all that, but it's nice to have it physically on disc.
A Rick Rude DVD would have had a lot of his WCW matches on it. Yeah. I can agree on that. 100%. Oh, look at that. Now both teams are just going at their non-legal opponents.
Yeah, but of course,
countouts
are in play here. These guys need to get back in the ring. Is that a free count here? And no, not the free count. That's something Ollie Davis likes to do.
One, two, three!
And no, I don't look like Luke Owen, guys. I mean, I'm not even bald. Damn it, Trav.
You remind us of a combination of Ryan Children. And, I just had the other guy's name.
Pete?
No.
Dan?
No.
Tempest?
No.
Laurie?
No, not Laurie. Andy Datson.
Wait a minute, going for the cover here. One. Oh, rope break.
That was smart by Trav helping his partner get to the rope there.
So what, you think I look like Brian Children and Andy Datson combined?
Yep.
Huh. Okay, maybe I should try and Photoshop myself in a photo of Brian Children or something. Maybe I should do that later. I'll have to post that on the Discord later. If I do. Oh, cut out! Oh, Cole with the cutter there. Oh, Nova taking down and tag again to Marcus.
You got a Ricky Steam by David for Christmas. Very nice.
Spear from Marcus.
Marcus might be looking to wrap this one up here.
Is it the Life Story of the Dragon DVD? Because I've got that. That's a really good one. Really good documentary on it. Oh, Trav tries to get a reversal. Something in, but didn't really work. And here comes Nova. And Nova, Jesus! Trav just Samoa Joe'd him. Lord, I think Trav has got himself a bit of a sweet tooth there. But Nova, oh, trying something out there, but didn't work. Trav, still in the fight. I mean, wouldn't you be surprised if Trav drove around in an ice cream van?
Oh, stop it.
Oh, damn it. Oh! Very familiar looking move there. I'm not sure. Maybe someone on the outside, I don't know. Trav going for the submission here. Oh, but... Oh! Nova takes him down there. What's Nova thinking? Oh, the Trav reverses. It's her strike. He hasn't gone up yet. Yeah, I don't see him. Oh, we have a blue thunder bomb there. Come on, Nova. Wait a minute, Nova going up top. Oh my god. Oh my god. Over the cover here. One, two. Oh. Oh my god. How many rotations was that from Nova? A 900? What does Nova think he's playing? Tony Hawk's Pro Skater? Always back up there. Maybe it's going to get here. One, two. Ooh, took out. Ooh, and Trav's going after Marcus. A little bit risky there as Nova's back up. Fighting me. Just continues to fight. I want to check out TNA back when it was good. Ah, yeah. I've got TNA Plus. It's really good. It definitely worth the Sabas. Oh, Marcus going for the cover here. One, two. Oh, no. And this crowd's loving them some tag team wrestling, don't you think? Big power bomb. And tagging back into Nova Adams. Nova seems to be the Iron Man of this match here. But then again, Trav. Trav also seems to be the Iron Man. Trav and Nova are the Iron Man of this match. And oh, wait a minute. Roll up, roll up. And he's like a TNA's lethal lockdown match. He's like TNA's lethal lockdown match. Oh, shotgun stunner! Shotgun stunner! One, two. Oh, not quite. Oh, man. Yeah, lethal lockdown was cool. My head was really cool. He's like, I know TNA Plus. Definitely going there. Cool. Damn it. I'm excited for the rebrand TNA pay-per-view this week. Oh, Hard to Kill is going to be great. I can't wait. Oh, Spanish Fly? What was that for Nova? Nova, going for the submission here. And it very much seems like... Oh, it seems like El Cold here is acting Hard to Kill here. As Nova goes for the cover. One, two... Quite! Ooh, disappointing there for Trav.
Wasn't quick enough!
very much wasn't quick enough for Trav and Colt there. So in the end, while they ain't getting a shot anytime soon, you'll say they were pretty impressive there.
Here are your winners, the Blood Brothers.
You gotta say, that was a pretty impressive performance from those two, even if they didn't get the job done.
All right, gentlemen, we're gonna take a couple minutes break. Stick around, we got more action coming up live on TCW.
Oh, it's gonna be good.
What? Not ending. Hang on, hold on, hold on. Hold on. There we go. Demand a rematch? All right, we'll be right back.
Yep, there we go.
Alrighty.
I just had to mute my mic just in case my mic was coming up on the thing.
Alrighty.
Some shit.
Now, wait, what?
What?
So, wait, what do you mean he's had the... Wait. Wait, what?
What are you hearing?
A Sam's title shot? What?
What's this about?
Why? Apparently Chris Masters is gonna challenge Mad Dog right now for the search title? In the impromptu?
What?
Wait, what?
What? You're serious, right? Wait a minute.
Hey, what the? Who the hell? Is that Mad Dog?
That doesn't look like Mad Dog to me.
Brock Lesnar!
That's the alpha male of our species! What the hell is Brock doing here?
We're supposed to be having a TCW Search title match right now!
Good lord,
God, I thought it was going to be Trav's nightmare to have to deal with Chris Masters if he won the belt, but... Oh my God. Brock Lesnar's laying here.
Brock Lesnar is assaulting the honor of this bloody company.
Not pays his damn bills. Like, why? Why would Brock do this?
Brock pays his own bills, you mean?
Well, Masters gives him the money. Obviously.
What the hell? Wait, Masters!
Masters going for a comeback here.
For Masters about to hit a bloody
F5.
Yeah, but where is Mad Dog in all this? It's supposed to be scheduled a Surge title match.
Yeah, I wonder. I mean, this is...
Oh my God.
This is ridiculous. Crazy, you sent me the DM. I'll take a look at that. But, oh my God.
Now's not the time.
Now's not the time, mate. I'll sort it out after this is done here, but... Oh my God, going for a bear hug. You don't see Brock Lesnar doing bear hugs.
I mean, really, a bear hug from Brock Lesnar is a bloody, you know, steel girdle just being an anaconda wrapping around you, constricting you. But Lesnar, like, this is not, you don't just come out here and randomly attack the owner of this bloody company. Like, there's gonna be ramifications for this.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if Brock gets suspended or something. Hell, I wouldn't be surprised if Brock gets his spot changed in the Rumble. I wouldn't be surprised.
Oh my God!
Jesus! How is Masters able to lift up someone as massive as Brock?
Hold on. We're gonna Navi on replay for that.
Yeah,
holy
go, Navi,
hell.
Go. Yeah, let's take a look at this. Brock Lesnar laying in there with the strikes. Just continual striking action here. Look at that. Brock Lesnar just laying into the owner, trying to bust him open. Like, look, I get Chris Masters definitely has his problems, but you don't have to get this pissed about it. Masters just lays into him again.
They're still fighting it right now as we speak, though, ladies and gentlemen. Like, we just got back here just for the replay. Like, look, this is something.
And look at this. He just picks him up, throws him into the sky.
God. Oh God. Oh!
Jesus! The steps! Oh my God. What do you think is gonna happen to Brock Lesnar now that he's done this?
Well, I don't know. It depends if Brock Lesnar survives, I guess. Master seems to be, flying back here.
I mean, considering everything Masters has dealt with.
Oh, Brock! Oh no, Brock's been busted. Oh no, that second health bar's just been unlocked.
Oh no. I mean, man, considering everything we've seen Masters go through over the last few weeks, of course he'd be pissed off.
Oh.
Like, Brock Lesnar is just the catalyst for all this anger we're seeing here from Masters. You do not want to mess with the beast.
Well, Masters right now is trying to mess with the beast here. Sends Brock into the ring here. Still no sign of Mad Dog and the Search Championship.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I don't see any sign of Brock Lesnar's friend, Juicy Field. I don't see him anywhere. Do you see him?
How are they friends? Oh no, come on, oh no, he's gonna break his damn arm! No, Brock!
Oh,
damn
God,
Brock! He's your meal ticket! Brock! Brock! Brock!
Oh God, he's trying to break his damn arm, but Masters reverses.
Oh no, Masters
trips. I mean, legit, Bobby Juicy Field and Brock Lesnar seem to have a bit of a business relationship. That's what it seems like to me. They seem to be being all buddy-buddy.
Oh no, oh God, no. Oh.
He just like a Bobby saw earlier tonight, but
oh. Well, didn't clock it all. That shot in. Masters. Oh.
Oh, the knee. Oh my God. Just to say, if Masters was able to superplex Brock, that would have broke the damn ring. Like, you know.
Oh. Big power slam there from Masters. Masters telling Brock, you're going to pay.
Clearly, he's making it.
Oh, now what's he thinking here?
Oh, he's going back for the steel steps. Good look, those steel steps. Oh, and he dropped them. I was about to say those steel steps with the sword.
His arms is going to be hurt. He can't lift the steel steps. Remember, he got put into a bloody Kimura. What a lariat. With the sore arm too, so you know that wasn't as powerful as it could be, but still enough to flip the Beast Incarnate.
Yeah, still enough as he punches him around the outside. Oh. Lesnar with a reversal. Masters, what's he looking for? A big throw? How is he able to throw Brock Lesnar? Oh my God, the steps of the surge printing.
I mean, Brock was in a match at the start of the night, so he's not at 100%. How did Masters lose those steps in? I don't know. Masters just... Oh, no. Little elbow in the eye. Masters now just throwing whatever he can here, and Brock pushes him off.
Yeah, it almost looked like he was trying to bust him open even further.
Oh. Is he trying to maul him? What the hell?
I was trying to injure him. I think he's trying to injure Brock.
Oh no.
No. Oh, thank God. Thank God.
Oh.
If those two were the superplex, they would have broke the ring.
Why? We got a guillotine here.
What, a guillotine on Brock?
I mean, Brock's... Oh! Masters gets bust up with Brock's knee. Oh, the boot by the Beast. And the Beast now smells the blood.
He is the alpha male of our species, after all. Oh, God.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, no. Brock. Brock, come on, man. Brock.
No.
Oh, my God. Masters is reeling.
I mean, look, Masters has his problems,
Brock,
but...
Brock, here's your meal ticket. Don't do it.
This is too far, Brock. He's the one who pays your damn
Chris,
bill.
Chris, no, he's don't do it. Chris, talk to him.
Good Lord. Oh, my God. There has to be some repercussions there.
Now, what type of authority figure does that? That is blatant disrespectful.
Look, that may be disrespectful, but...
He attacked Brock first.
I don't know what to say. How did Masters survive? How?
Conspiracies. Why don't we go ask why don't we ask Alex Jones, the MGB?
Conspiracies? How the fuck be conspiracies when it comes to old Brock Lesnar and his opponent there?
Alrighty. T7 Television title is your co-main event, ladies and gentlemen. We've got this and then our main event. So, who walks out as TV champion? Who challenges Yamashita? We are going to find out in a matter of moments, ladies and gentlemen.
I mean, there is a stacked roster here on Surge. It could be anyone from this amazing roster.
I mean, hell, it could be El Colt.
It could be Trev. I mean, it could be him.
It could be Juicy J.
Oh, yeah, of course Juicy J would probably consider doing that.
Hell.
Obviously, it wouldn't be Brock Lesnar because he just got brutalized.
Well, let's get there and find out. We don't know, Trump, is this a one-on-one? It has to be.
Who knows? Who knows here? Oh!
Wait, what?
The following contest is a fatal four-way ladder match.
A what?
I mean,
a fatal four-way ladder match?
And we're starting with a former undisputed champion?
The TV titles come back to the YVB?
And you have to think as well, BK could consider cashing in his undisputed title rematch clause if he chooses. He could. So, I'm intrigued to see how this goes. Huh?
What the?
This pyro. Wait a minute.
Oh no.
Don't tell me. Don't tell me what I'm thinking. Are you thinking it?
I mean, it could be anyone who uses the bloody judgment. Oh, Jesus Christ, no!
Things are about to get interesting. Because when it comes to ladder matches, I mean, this guy's basically undefeated in them.
Wait a minute. Well, that's not MJB.
Hang on.
Priest?
What? Why did he need to bring out Dom Dom? I mean, look, Dom Dom's cool, but he doesn't need him. Well, I mean, in ladder matches, this guy has been undefeated, so that could be a good sign.
The challenger, representing tons of fun, from Australia, weighing in at 281 pounds.
I mean, this man came up short in a triple threat match for the Undisputed Championship, lost a surge belt in the opening bout of the night. Things have not been good for our, you know, for our Pico, the old Wingull here.
Yeah, that is correct as well, but as I just mentioned, I mean, undefeated in ladder matches, so...
Are you sure about that?
I'm sure. I'm sure about that. I mean, he's won the Surge and Tag titles in ladder matches, so...
Hang on.
You have to be... That could be an advantage. What?
Well, now someone's going to be the TV champion, so who's the last challenger? And of course, it's the Winnipeg Love Child.
Oh boy, things are about to get interesting.
It's Canada's favorite son, Max Cooper.
I guess it's faction warfare, folks. With a little sprinkling of Yamashita. I mean, we've got representative of the Wolfpack, a representative of the YVB, and a representative of Team Pop C in this match, so... It's gonna be interesting to see how they deal with each other. Because, I mean, the Wolfpack hates the YVB, the YVB hates Team Pop C, and... Well, Team Pop C seems to be indifferent with the Wolfpack, so... That could be a bit of an advantage for Yamashita. Because those guys could be fighting each other. Could that be a good advantage? I mean, just look at Max here. He is mentally ready. He's looking for gold again. He is looking for that TV gold. But in order to get it, he's gonna have to survive this man. Who could walk out tonight, potentially, as a double potentially the near future as a double champion.
I was about to say, hang on a minute.
Yeah, I had to correct myself there a little bit, but you know, you got to think for Yamashita. I think it's a good thing how the three other opponents are part of three factions who have problems with each other. That could be a good advantage point for him. I mean, while the other guys are fighting each other, he could take the title. No worries there, mate. Hope you have a good time doing your stuff, mate.
See you, Chris.
Man, you gotta think. Who do you think has got the best chance of winning the TV title here? Who are you betting on to win it?
Well, because I'm not a biased commentator or anything, I think Yamashita is going to retain. He's going to overcome this multi-man curse that he's so well known for.
I mean, in this scenario, you got to think for Yamashita. The other three, they could be dealing with each other here, and we're seeing it right now here. So, you have to think that could be a good advantage for Yamashita.
I mean, the only thing Max Cooper has done in the last 6 months is shock the world and beat Brock Lesnar.
Yeah, that is the case. But look, while I normally would pick MGB in this scenario, and especially considering that he's been undefeated in ladder matches, I think BK might have a good shot at this. I mean, he recently lost the Undisputed title. He was recently a world champion, so you got to think, that experience of being a champion in these big matches, that could help him.
Wing Galb, I'll point to his flock there.
Oh,
go away!
Back out with the split.
Ooh. I'll have a look after and I'll reply to you.
Hell yeah.
MGB just sends BK into the ring.
Yeah, I mean, MGB and BK, they still are not finished after their whole scenario.
I mean, at the end of the day, they both came out losers.
Yeah, and, oh, looking at the padded stats, MGB already with a point.
They're all down to it, just going. Oh! Oh, ooh, no, BK, Show's been alright. It's been okay.
Yeah, it's been pretty good.
Oh. Need it for Cooper.
I mean, look, man, I could see BK potentially winning it. Like, I could see it happening.
Wait, the rumble got leaked? Pretty sure that's fake.
Yeah, normally rumble leaks would be considered. Oh, wait a minute. Who's that got it?
Cooper.
Oh, Yamashita. Oh. Oh, MGB soaring through the sky.
Yeah, it has to be fake.
Yeah. I mean, there's never really been a time where, like, the whole list has been fully leaked. It's never happened before.
I mean, look, let's be honest. I think it's a change it. What is this wing goal doing? Oh,
he's setting up a ladder bridge.
Oh, why? Why are you doing that for, you silly bird?
I think he wants to throw someone through the ladder.
No.
Oh, he throws BK onto the ladder. God. Now, even if the ladder didn't break, that is still gonna hurt.
I still don't think it'd be real. It'd be a real photo. Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, hey.
Time to put a bird to sleep.
With BK going for the sleeper here. I think he's learned a little bit from Wrestle Kingdom. But OMGB fighting back. Oh.
One day he's put his mask on the line. Oh, it's, oh, right, okay. Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah. Lag of surprise entrance means that it's fake.
Spear!
Oh! Good lord.
Again, BK. Right, oh, wait a minute, Cooper. Cooper!
Oh, Cooper, what's he thinking?
Oh, MGB. I don't know what MGB's trying to think here.
I think he wants to get BK taken care of. I think he wants to be the one to take out BK.
Oh.
But I heard someone saying about putting the mask on the line. I mean, if he really had to, he could consider it. But you know MGB probably wouldn't consider it at all. Like, this isn't bloody Kane in 2003.
I like to try to create the only way pro wrestling would be able to get back to the violent hardcore again, like it was if the post-apocalyptic world. Yeah. True. I mean, you've got, like, your death matches and shit.
Your comedy wrestling. Oh, MGB,
this is a ladder match, not a stairs match.
Yeah, this is TLCS.
JDS!
I mean, yes, this is no DQ, but it doesn't mean you can get any old weapon and use it.
Oh, God.
Oh, what's MGB thinking? Oh, he kicked him in the gut?
Big wing attack? Yeah, there's deathmatch promotions. Yeah, like DMDU.
CZW.
Big ZZW.
Yeah, and the BCW.
How about them Brits? Pretty good, right? Pretty good, Brits. Pretty good. Oh, Cooper now! Oh, no.
Should be
Yabba Yabba Shana. Oh, my God! Oh, my...
He just broke the damn... thing. Oh my God, what timing. MGB, let's see, he's looking for it, looking to become a two-time champ. Is he gonna do it?
Oh, BK saving the title.
This is risky. Oh, MGB here. Oh my God,
wait a minute.
Yamashita. Yamashita throws him down. Oh my God, MGB. He's surveying the scene. Wait a minute. Oh my God. He's almost gone.
Oh, Cooper. Cooper and hardball. And BK.
Oh no.
Oh. Hello, Carl 2812. Welcome on in.
Good to see you.
Oh my God, whoever gets pretty much up that ladder next will be a TV champion. Yamashita is just struggling here. Now, I believe this match was booked by Juicy J.
Oh my God, the kick! He just knocked him the fuck out.
Get that ladder. I was gonna say Yamashita. Get that ladder. Get that ladder, Yamashita.
Oh,
Cooper drops the ladder. Turns it back towards Yamashita. And we have a sleeper here.
Going for that sleeper.
Little stunner.
Oh, stunner.
Oh.
I'm telling you, this match has been as brutal
BK,
as we
thought. What's he thinking here? BK should go for the climb. BK's going for the climb.
Oh, BK. BK's getting it. He's got that ladder set
BK.
Up.
Oh, no.
MGB. MGB's right at him.
The ladder. Oh, very close. Yamashita in the corner. BK is going to put a bed to sleep.
Oh, this is risky.
Oh. Shane should bring back Ridden in my face.
He should.
One of my favorite steel cage matches is the Benoit Angle one.
What's BB doing? Oh! Continuing to lay the BK there.
So now that's a good idea by MGB.
And he missed it there. He missed it.
Oh! Oh! That's a backstabber!
I think that is a backstabber. That's new.
Where the hell did that chair come from?
I don't know. Oh my God. Well, you never see MGB doing backstabbing.
Yes, that straight fight with Shay with the glass of King of the Ring. I 100% agree on that. Oh, Cooper. Cooper, you've been through that ladder once, mate. You don't need to go through it again. Yamashita just grabbed the ladder.
Oh, Cooper. Cooper, what? Oh, he just lays the ladder on BK here. What are these guys doing?
Oh. BK's gonna be out of it just for now.
Oh, Woodpecker, he just keeps giving up, man. That resiliency.
Oh.
He might be the most resilient wrestler I've seen.
Oh, Yamashita, climb! Yamashita, climb! No, put the chair down, you idiot!
Oh, BK. Wait a minute, BK.
Cooper takes the ladder down. Puts in the corner.
Oh, what a tease. What a tease Cooper is. Cooper being such a tease there. What's MGB thinking? What's he thinking? And what is he doing? Oh, double team! Okay. Interesting. Well, with a lariat. And BK going right behind. MGB. What's he attempting?
Oh, Cooper just gets blown over. Yamashita.
And MGB suplex. Could he hit it? Rainmaker!
And the Rainmaker just got smacked in the face. Oh, Cooper. Oh, no.
No way. No way is he going to do it. No way. Yamashita getting up. It is now a race to the ladder.
Go for the ladder, Yamashita. Oh, don't go for the fucking chair, you idiot. Oh. Yamashita, climb!
MGB,
what are you doing?
BK.
Oh my God, Yamashita!
What's BK thinking? Ooh!
Yamashita could be the television champion right now.
Yeah. Oh, wait a minute, BK. Wait a minute, MGB, what's he thinking? Oh my God, what is he doing?
Oh, Yamashita!
Oh my God. BK climbing the ladder. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Yamashita! He told BK to climb! BK!
No way!
The 5VB have got a title again!
God damn
it! BK's your new television champion. Yamashita's told BK, go for it!
What the hell was Yamashita thinking?
I think Yamashita has got his mind set on the Intercontinental Championship.
Yamashita just screwed over so many competitors there. And he just screwed himself.
Champion will be Kane.
Oh my God, Yamashita screwed himself over just to let
classic
BK
bumps you'll never see again in wrestling. All the ones we followed you, yes. Yep.
Oh my God.
through for Yamashita, but Yamashita, you saw him. He's like, BK, go for it.
But he asked BK to get it. I mean, that was Yamashita's belt. Yamashita should have walked in double champ.
Doesn't matter now. BK's your new TCW Television Champion. But, ladies and gentlemen, that's not even it. We have a main event. It is the winner of the Ted Jr. Over the Top Rope Christmas Battle Royale, Peter Tarr, fighting Opox. Inside. Now, if I believe this correctly, is the Opoden match for the Intercontinental Champion. What? Peter wins this. Oh, he could walk in on power to fight for the Oceania Championship as the IC champ. All to gain, all to lose. Let's go down the ring for your main event.
I mean, considering Opo's in the Opoden, that is a massive advantage. Here we go.
We're not even getting into the bloody entrances here. These guys are not wasting time here.
And they do not want to waste time. They want to fight.
All right. Okay. We're doing this. Oh,
good lord. I still can't believe what we just saw in the TV title match. And you know for a fact, Old Woodpecker and BK, that they aren't done. But still, right now, our focus is this match here, and Opo's getting scored here by BK. Oh, God.
I mean, Opo is your submission specialist, so he's got the advantage here. Peter, not really known for submissions.
That is true. That is definitely true.
But if anyone can do it, it's Peter Tarr.
Exactly. I mean, Peter, he's one of those guys you do not want to mess with.
I mean, Peter's a former world champion and a former Money in the Bank. Armbar!
That is correct, but when it comes to Peter lately, everyone's been hoping he does something, but lately he hasn't done much, so let's hope he can do something here.
He's holding his own so far. More or less a feeling out process here.
I mean, this is the Opo Den. I don't think he's ever been inside this structure. That 15-foot-high cage.
Oh! You heard the crack of something.
I believe there's a roof on the cage. I can't tell exactly. Can you tell if there's a roof on the cage?
I can't tell, no.
Oh. These two are just laying it here in the 15 feet of steel.
Oh.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Cradle DDT there from Opo to Peter.
I mean, yeah.
Is that armbar?
Opo, the submission magician. I mean, you have to think, whoever wins this match, they've got a long list of challengers who are looking at that Intercontinental Championship. Not just the tournaments, but there's a fair few people who want that gold.
Take that again. These open palm strikes.
Opo thinks he's in Kill Bill. Look at the gill. The gear makes him look like he's in Kill Bill.
Again! Opo's just outpacing Peter.
Yeah, in this case, it's not Kill Bill, it's Kill Peter. Yeah, my pop culture references are on point tonight.
And Pete's been
busted open.
Was it Opo or Pete?
Oh! Yeah, it looked like Peter was hitting the strikes there on Opo, so must have been Opo that got busted open.
What's Peter thinking here? Oh, spear!
He's doing something! He's doing something!
Oh, there's no way.
Oh my god, what's he thinking? Running power slam!
running 3D power slam by Peter Tarr.
Oh my god, he's doing something. He's doing something.
Peter! Shoulder tackle from the second rope.
Can he do it? Can he do it?
It's a submission match though. Drop down. Ah!
Big slam from Oppo.
Oh, try to work on the arm again. Kate blocks it. Kate still yet to put a submission in.
Yeah, Peter has not considered that.
Oh, submission. Wait a minute. Brock lock?
What?
Peter went for Brock lock?
That's new. That is definitely new from Peter. I guess Peter was preparing just in case this was an Oppo dead match.
Oh. Peter!
Man, tonight we've seen a lot of people doing some different offense.
Peter just outpowering Oppo here.
What's Peter
doing? Another shoulder barge.
He's doing something, all right.
Pete, stay focused. Pete's got to stay focused here. Don't talk. What are you doing, Peter?
Oh my God! Good Lord, that's gonna hurt being taken
eight
down.
Eight defeat.
Oh man. Wait a minute, Peter's back up. How the hell did he get back up into eight defeat that quickly?
Well,
Peter
I'm
is
tired.
A man possessed here.
Okay. Oh.
I mean, this is Oppo's specialty. This is Oppo's match. He
hasn't got a perfect record in this match type, though. He has lost a couple of Oppo dents. I believe in Peter!
Can Peter do it? That is the question.
If Oppo keeps outpacing like this, then no. Oh.
Oh, God, just landing onto the head.
Take it. Oh, ankle lock.
Oh, my God, a Kurt Angle special.
And Greg finds it? Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
Oh, wait a minute, Peter.
Oppo there with a Kurt Angle special, but it just didn't work out there.
Oh, Pete comes lodging in. Lariat.
I mean, Peter is a big guy. You do have to think that
oh.
as well. That probably could help him.
Oh, running free day print slam.
I think he printed something good there. He goes after the arm and oh, what's he thinking?
Oh, come on, Peter. Just. Grinds his face into the mat. Oh no, has he got Brock lock again?
Oh my god, the Brock lock.
Oppo's in trouble! Oppo's in trouble!
Is he gonna tap?
And Pete's angry so Oppo can't kick as easy.
Is he gonna do something? Will he do something?
Oppo is in trouble here. He's struggling. He finally gets his feet up.
Oh, he doesn't do something.
Oh!
Oh my god, Peter with a comeback. The two lariats.
Oh!
The third two.
Peter!
Oh my god, going up top.
Oh no!
Oh my god! Oh,
again, you idiot!
I'm telling you, that is the risk of going top rope in a match like this.
You should be going to the top rope.
Oh, the power bomb.
Oh, Pete got an elbow.
Oh my god, Peter just somehow fighting back. Oppo.
Oppo just outpaced him there.
Yeah. Oppo with the punches.
Oh. Yeah, Oppo's Oppo trying to bust him open.
Yeah, Oppo needs to be very careful here, though. Need to be very careful with the offense he brings here.
Oh! Wait, Peter!
Peter, what the hell is this?
What the hell?
Wait a minute. He's done something! He did something! Peter Tarr has done something, folks!
Peter Tarr is your new TCW Intercontinental Champion and has just made Oppo tap out!
I can't believe that Peter Tarr has actually done something.
As we look back here, it's that left arm is trapped. Oppo has to submit. Oppo is trapped like a rat there.
Here is your winner, and new Intercontinental Champion, the Redneck, Peter Tarr.
Has just achieved half of his goals for the week. Peter walking into power as your new Intercontinental Champion.
And say, whoever wins the tournament, they've got one hell of a challenge against Peter. Wow.
All right, it's time for the news.
This is the news.
Bam! 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 Peter Tarr is your new Intercontinental Champion. BK is your new Television Champion.
Somehow,
he's
injured. I told you. The ribs, man. The ribs. The ribs might be broken.
Oh,
Lord, but this is concerning. Bullfrog's ribs might be broken.
Oh, dear. Where are you, Red? I was actually going to send you a message, Jackson, after to see how you're traveling. Oh, hang on. Okay, yep. Yeah, I'll tell him. No worries. Okay, we have some breaking news here, ladies and gentlemen, from the office of Chris Masters. Brock Lesnar has officially been stripped of the number 30 spot in the TCW Rumble following his actions tonight against Froggy and against Chris Masters.
Oh, shit. So is he still in the Rumble, though? That's my question.
Well, That's all that we can tell, but Chris Masters has stated that officially Brock Lesnar is now no longer the number 30 entrant.
Oh, wow. That is big.
So we're going to have to figure out a way of who gets number 30 now.
I mean, could be anyone at this point.
Yeah. Could be anyone. Anyway, folks, we're going to wrap it up there. Slow start to the show, but it sort of picked up towards the end there. I love my energy levels, if I'm being honest.
Yeah.
Man,
I gotta say, that was insane. Like, that TV title match had me in emotions you wouldn't believe.
Alright, let's see here.
Let's
we go from here, Chant?
And who is live at this time of the evening?
Well, let's have a look in the channels here.
Yeah. You know, I should mention this. I haven't mentioned it on the live properly yet, but I've actually been getting into supercards lately, and good lord, I've been loving it.
Oh, so. Wait, CM Punk's coming to Supercard.
And apparently you can get them for free if you, like, do, like, the draws.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff to get it, but, you know, that's a story for another day.
Yeah. Looks like you're going to have to be grinding out money in the bank then.
Yay, that's all we need.
Oh, boy.
Oh, dear. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, that is where we are going to leave it for tonight. Let's see here. Who are we going to?
Yeah. I'll check to see who's on my list.
Yeah, we'll go to this guy. We'll go to another person in the category. Alrighty, chat. Right, you know the drill. Yeah, especially because we're going to a new place.
Ooh. How fitting with like the music going.
Oh, if only. Oh. Spam that TCW emote. Go say hello to Emma, Mr. Motar. Go say hello to Mr. Motar 420. And also use tomorrow for some SmackDown VROA. We continue Jeff Hardy season mode. Thank you, Tyler. Have a good night,
no
chat.
No problemo. Have a good one, guys.